वेलकम बैक। टुडेज़ टॉपिक इज़ अबाउट फास्टिडियस माइक्रोब्स। सो व्हाट इज़ द मीनिंग ऑफ फास्टिडियस? इट मीन्स स्पेसिफिक रिक्वायरमेंट और स्पेसिफिक सेट ऑफ रिक्वायरमेंट दैट इज़ वेरी नेसेसरी फॉर अ पर्टिकुलर माइक्रोब और अ बैक्टीरिया टू ग्रो, राइट? सो दिस इज़ अ क्लास, नॉट क्लास, दिस इज़ अ टाइप ऑफ माइक्रोब्स दैट एक्चुअली यू फाइंड those are pathogens, okay? They are very fastidious. We know that each organism has different requirement for growth, okay? So some require specific set which are known as fastidious, while one which are easy to grow are known as non-fastidious. For example, the bacteria which grow on NA are non-fastidious, while the one which grows on a specific media like blood agar, those are fastidious, because blood in that medium is a supplement that is required for that pathogen or a particular microbe to grow. Okay, so these are some specific requirements which these mostly those are pathogens, so they require for their growth. So why do we need to provide them these specific set of requirements? As we need to study them, we have to first grow them successfully, right? So that's why we need to provide them their requirements. That can be in case of temperature, in case of nutrients or other supplements. Okay, so there are many different types of fastidious microbes which has different requirements to ensure their successful growth, right? So we are going to study here around 4 to 5 examples. Okay, so first is Helicobacter pylori. So this is a pathogen that resides in gastrointestinal tract, and it is known to cause gastritis and stomach ulcer. Okay, so to cultivate H. pylori in lab, it requires supplementation of blood to grow. It also requires low oxygen tension and demanding the use of micro aerophilic container. Okay, so this is the requirement for Helicobacter pylori to grow in lab, right? So if you can cultivate H. pylori successfully, then you can study it. Next example is Campylobacter jejuni. This is again the microbe that causes GI diseases, gastrointestinal diseases, in both, actually in humans and animals. It has same low, it requires very low oxygen condition. It is, that's why known as micro aerophilic, and it grows at 5% CO2 and 10% CO2 to minimize the damage from the oxygen related products. Okay, so the condition is it can grow at 5% CO2 and 10% CO2. Okay, so that means that oxygen requirement is low and it requires the CO2. It grows well in lyced broth, which has 5% lyced blood, sodium pyruvate, sodium metabisulfate, and ferrous sulfate, right? So this is the kind of, we can say, some components that we need to have in the media to grow Campylobacter jejuni. So next example, that is third, is of Haemophilus influenza. It is found in respiratory system, and it causes upper respiratory system or upper respiratory tract infections. Okay, it also requires blood as supplement with NAD factor, that is nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide, with 5% CO2. Okay, then fourth example is of Neisseria gonorrhoeae, and it also requires blood or hemoglobin and several amino acids and vitamins to grow. Okay, so other examples for fastidious organisms are Legionella, Leptospira, then Bartonella and Bordetella. Okay, so these are some genus that I had listed here. Okay, so for Viva questions, you may get a question that what are fastidious microbes, or give some examples. So you can describe any of these, right? I hope this video is useful to you all, and do subscribe to my channel, and please share these videos with your friends. Thank you.